host, Stan Boardman.
The Liverpool Festival of Comedy and Music started today, and those are some of the artists that can be seen in the city during the next 2 weeks and in our show tonight. Here is a very talented scouser, both musical and funny. It's Richard Stilgoe.
We have an annual ceremony in Liverpool called the Last Grand National. I've been to about 20 of these now, I think. When I was a boy, after the Last Grand National, we always used to go to the Gilbert and Sullivan because they were always on tour in Liverpool during Grand National Week. And so, over the years, they've become sort of confused in my memory.
And he'll join us in time for the starter to climb to his rostrum by means of a ladder. I can see every horse lining up on the course, and they're all getting madder and madder. While the jockeys all strain to keep hold of the reins, the horses to start are all fretting. As they try to get cool, it is over to Julian Wilson for news of the betting.
Well, thanks, Peter. Still, it is Raquel, the filly, who's favourite at 8 to 11. Corbiere's lengthened to 13s in strength, and Grease Paints at 100 to 7. And Key of the Door is at 7 to 4. He has hardened since winning at Weatherby. While Battle of Fun is 100 to 1. It's as good as his chances will ever be. Wrought Iron Gate is 100 to 8, and I'm sorry I can't be completer. I must stop, for I hear a voice in my ear, so it's back at the start with you, Peter.
And they're now under orders, though herbaceous borders. Still obviously not too well. And their orphan St. Heart was left at the start, and the first one to show is Perel. Then it's Santa Carrera, Moondance, Buena Sera, Dutch Ill Disease, Buttercup Fire. These are followed by Dream, Handy Man, Clotted Cream, Lion Hunt, Cupid's Bow, My Desire. Then it's Lancashire Rose, Mary Ann Parsons Nose, Powder Keg, and the Grey Nosy Parker. Then Afternoon Girl, Rowan Bush in a Whirl, and Tattooist, and he's the back marker. As they come to the first, it's Raquel, Randolph Hearst, they're all over except Bingo Caller. Mitch and Princess goes to Mercy Me and Sky Blue, and President Ford is a faller. As they go out of sight, it's Keith on the right and Dean Martin behind Double Features. I shall hand over there to Michael O'Hare as they come for the first time to Beecher's.
And they're over that well, and still it's Raquel who's well out in front of the course. But Newcastle Brown and the Shaker brought down by a riderless runaway horse. And Starsky and Hutch are both also in touch, and Untouchable is still there. With Scarface, Malone and Big Al Capone as they cross Valentine's in the chair. Fortunata Foundation and Paddington Station are still there with Princess of Wales, who is still sitting pretty behind in the city, who's badly blocked in on the rails. These five are the leaders, the other four bleeders. I can't see them, rather unsighted. So now I shall hand you all back to the stand, and I'm sorry I get so excited.
I've gone now to the four by a lake, but his Corbiere now, he must be on his guard. But he may well not stay, and now here's British Leyland being pushed terribly hard. British Leyland is down, so he's sending the clouds, and the last West Tip has given them the slip. He has done it, he's there, he's in clover. There's a lump in my throat, thank God there's no photo. The National is through, and my commentary too.
And thank goodness, they're both of them over.
Richard will be back again in the series of I Feel Fine, which starts later this year. So will our next Scouse guest, Mick Miller.
I've had a request. So I'm gonna do a thing. Can you imagine a fellow on the radio doing the Noddy programme for kids? And he hates kids. He needs kids like a moose needs a hat rack. And he's been doing this for 20 years, every Monday morning, on the radio, the Noddy programme for kids. He hates kids, and he's an alcoholic. Don't forget it's on the radio, and I think it'd sound something like this. Morning, kids. Are you all listening to your radios? What does Noddy do today? He wakes up, doesn't he? And he goes in the bathroom for a wash. Can you hear Noddy? Turning the tap on. Pours himself water into the sink. He's got a very big sink, hasn't he? Then he empties the sink, and doesn't it make a funny noise? Then he went downstairs for his breakfast. There's the milkman. Pours himself a cup of tea. Pour himself some breakfast. Runny egg. Then he got in his car. And he's going on his hollandaise. Scotty bottling. And he met a Scottish Red Indian. Hawkeye the New. Then he met a Scouse Red Indian. Hang on a mo. And he's driving along and his car stopped.
Noddish said, oh, my gosh, won't go. And he phoned the AA man. And the AA man said, what's wrong, eh? Hey? Found there was no water in the radiating, Nathan. Bloody big radiating, Nathan. No water in the wiper washes. No water in the headlamps. There they go, it's a big ears house. And he went up and knocked on the door. Sorry, Mike. Said, no, he's knocking your door, let us in, you bloody big ears. He opened the door and he said, big ears, I hate you. Your wallpaper stinks. He said, I'm Noddy. I'm the prat with a bell on me hat. He said, I'm sick of you going down Toy Town Arms to get drunk. And he walked in Toy Town Arms and they're all there, Bill and Ben. Bill said, it's blowing nice, blowing nice, blowing nice. He said, splash, 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 splash. Noddy. Noddy said, go home, you're drunk. Thanks for being lovely people. Have a sweet break.
It's nostalgia time. Three of the best Merseyside groups from the 60s and are still going strong. It's the Swing and Blue Jeans, Mike Penn and Searchers, and the Merseybeats!
Feeling better, now that we're through. I'm feeling better, cause I'm only you. I've learned my lesson and left a scar, and now I see how you really are. You're no good, you're no good, you're no good, baby, you're no good. I'm gonna say it again, you're no good, you're no good, you're no good, baby, you're no good. Broke her heart, she's gentle and true. I left a girl for someone like you. I'll beg her forgiveness or mend at me, but I wouldn't blame her if she said to me, you're no good, it's no good, it's no good, baby, it's no good. I'm gonna say it out loud, it's no good, it's no good, it's no good, baby, it's no good.
Smart. I want her heart, didn't think I'd do, but now I see she's worse to him than me. Let her go ahead, take his love instead, and one day she'll see just how to say please. And get down on her knees, yeah, that's how it begins. My face, I can feel same place. I can hear the guitars playing lovely tunes. Every time there's you walking the room. I see summer's night with a magic moon. Every time that you walk in the room. Every time that you walk in the room.
The Scouse lady with a thousand voices, but we only have time for a couple of them tonight. So here she is, Faith Brown.
Supermarket girls, eh? Now, you know, me dad loves me next guest.
Now, she really makes a spectacle of herself and all. She's a right Nana. Mascari. Come on, Nana. I should change my style of singing like Chris Jones and Tina Turner, and I remember saying, how would you like your teeth as a necklace? I've always been as blind as a bat. I don't.
Such a class. They'll be appearing at the festival during the next 2 weeks, conducted by Barry Wordsworth, playing the Boston Pops arrangements of that well-known Beatles hit, Eleanor Rigby, is the Royal Liverpool Philharmonic Orchestra.
Thank you. Mick's Fruit and Fibre's favourite. At breakfast time each day, it's simply exquisite. It's the crunchy whole wheat flakes that sort of you wide awake.
But us, we're really nuts about the lovely fruit in it. It's more than crispy whole wheat flakes if you ask me. Kellogg's Fruit and Fibre's fruity too, just see. Apples, hazelnuts, bananas, raisins, coconuts, sultanas.
It's more than protein.
Crunchy fruity.
We agree.
My life has changed beyond recognition thanks to the healthy eating programme at Tesco. More and more Tesco products have information panels to help you plan a healthy diet. How much protein and fat, how high the fibre, how low the salt. Now it's stone-ground, high-fibre wholemeal bread for me. And because it's all from Tesco, you can afford to eat more than once a week. Well, you've got to go about these things gradually.
Tesco. Higher standards, lower prices.
Now we can show you the new Sunsilk hairsprays. The new Sunsilk hairsprays hold the look.
Always pass on your postcode so you're properly addressed when people reply. Because postcoded letters whiz through our machines far faster than sorting by hand. So pass on your postcode. Write it, quote it, use it. It means mail gets sorted faster, helping us to help you.
Pass on your postcode, you're not properly addressed without it.
Alone and lovelorn in Ealing, Bill McKenzie decides to give his girlfriend a tinkle. In Australia. One of 162 countries you can now dial direct.
Bill.
Bill is immensely cheered to hear she loves him more than words can tell and considers £2.47 a small price to pay for three such happy minutes.
Oh, so lovely to meet you. Oh.
It's no big deal to dial direct.
Side has always produced great groups, and here are two of the current chart toppers. It's Immaterial and The Real Thing.
When I leave your door, when we say goodnight, it hurts me more and more. This girl, it just ain't right to end a day like this with no more than a kiss. Spend the night just dreaming of the things we're gonna miss. If I had my way, girl, we'd be together more and more each day. And we'd go on forever, lovers hand in hand. Can't you understand? Girl, you've got to be my woman, I've got to be your man.
Can't get by without you, I need you more each day.
The way I feel about you, there's nothing more to say. Cause I love you, girl, I need you. And I can't get by without you,
no way.
Hey, it's good to see your face.
Hey, it's good to see your face.
Answer me that.
Now, here's a young lady from Merseyside who, like a lot of Scousers, does nothing for a living. A partner does all the work. It's Penny Page and Googi, the Liverpool Duck.
I'm just an ordinary duck, you'll see me in the street. Wandering around Liverpool, I've got wellies on my feet. And I stood there, I was looking up at the life of buildings. Oh, Jesus, I thought. But old Liverpool, it never changes. When I looked down, the cases had gone. Oh, I'm awful glad I'm here tonight, because I've got to tell you, today, oh, God, I was so sad. Could you hear me, girl? She's deaf, you know. She thinks I'm still singing. Girl, I was just saying today I was really sad. Because you know me little dog? You know, our shittles. He died? Well, that's terribly tragic, Googi. What happened? Filling up now. I was teaching to wee in the gutter. Oh, good Lord, Googi, was it a traffic accident? No, he fell off the roof. Oh, God, aren't I good, aren't I? Oh, I wish he could sit out there and listen to myself. My brother's unlucky. Everything went wrong for him. He peeled a banana, and it was empty. And when he was little, he saved up all his pocket money so as he could have a packet after 8 months. And he melted at 7:30. And he's ugly. You know, he's so ugly, he frightened you. Every night, I used to listen to him saying his prayers. He used to say, "Please, God, make me handsome, and ask me mum to take the shutters off me carry cot." He was nearly 16. You know. Last year he won $75,000 on Littlewoods. New house, new Mercedes, new anorak. The lot. But his face, honest to God, it would frighten you. We decided to go down to Harley Street in London, have an operation on his gob. Well, he walked out the clinic at the end of the week, the most gorgeous looking devil you've ever seen in your life. Stand forward and go and eat your arse out. There's our Horace, walking across the road, singing, happy as a laddie, and a great big wagon knocked him down, stone dead. And he got to heaven. "Hey, God," he said. I think he knew him. "God," he said, "that was a lousy trick. You give me all the money, the car, the house, the anorak. You didn't give us the good looks and you killed me. How did you do it?" God said, "I'm awful sorry, son, I didn't recognize you." Thanks for being such a lovely audience. Sincerely, from my heart, you deserve me here tonight. Good night.
next guest featured on the record, which was made in aid of the Bradford Fire Disaster Fund. And it's just gone gold. So here he is with that Liverpool anthem, is Tony Christie.
When you walk through a storm, hold your head up high and don't be afraid of the dark. At the end of a storm, there's a golden sky and the sweet silver song of a love. Walk on through the wind, walk on through the rain, though your dreams be tossed and blown.
Back from holiday. I've been to Spain. We got him Spaniardos, you know. And no, I flew there, Air Flingus. I went in one of them Irish tours, you know, 7 days and three nights. I don't like flying. I hate flying. Who do you hate flying? I was there. You know, it doesn't help me when I'm in the taxi going to the airport. I'm taking Quells and Anadin and all that, you know. I'm terrified like that. And it doesn't help me when I get there and I get to the airport and they see that sign, terminal. I don't like going to Spain anymore, mate. I hate going to Spain, mate. Because, you know, have you noticed when you go there, they all hate us, you know. They do. There's bombs on the beaches now. Have you noticed that? Hey, why don't we go to Southport or New Brighton? No bombs on New Brighton's beaches, do nobody on you, Brighton. No, why should we go abroad, eh? Why don't we have our holidays in this? They all hate us. They do, don't they? Hey, and you get over there, I'll tell you what, you girls love the Spaniardos. Us fellas, we can't stand them, can we, lads? Hey, no, we're talking to the lads now. Don't we get humiliated in Spain, lads? Hey?
Yeah.
Yeah. All them Spaniardos chatting our girls, because our girls are the best in the world. Lying on the beaches in the bikinis. Then Spaniardos walking up and down, 4 foot three, little pucks like that. Two tennis balls down the kecks. We don't
care, do we, lads?
No.
We just lie there, not a danky braces. Pumps on in case the pub's open early. So while our girls are getting shattered up, what are we going to do, lads? What have we got? We've got to talk to all the people we've never met before in our lives at the bar. All right, mate, where are you from? Dusseldorf. But we're on holiday, we still talk to them. He's standing there like a little fat machinro. White pumps, white shorts, and a U-boat pilot's cap on. But we're on holiday. You come second in the last ward, and you're like... And then his wife comes in, a German Frau, 20 stone, eating a bacon sarnie. With a sweater on with cold dits. And you know where she's just been, don't you? This German woman. You know where she's been? She's just been out to put the towels on the deck chair for the next morning. Oh, hey! You do that, don't you? Hey! Have you been on holiday with the Germans? Hey! Do you sneak down the lift like the Gestapo with the towels at midnight? They put all the towels on the deck chair. We get up in the morning, all the deck chairs are taken. Do you do what I do? Come in at 4 o'clock in the morning, throw in the swimming pool. Yeah. Now. Yeah, I tell you what, no, why go abroad, eh? Why go abroad on the beaches in Spain where they're all blowing them up now, eh? I mean, it's all right coming home with a lovely tan. Say, oh, you look lovely, you've got a lovely tan. Oh, you should have seen me right leg, it was better than this. Now, I'm proud of you, British. And you, eh? Yeah. I was proud of our lads in the Falklands, wasn't you?
Yeah.
I'd have gone myself, but I was working that night. I'd have sorted them argy-bargies out, me, wouldn't you? Hey, and they still haven't declared that the war's over, have they? They haven't admitted that we beat them, eh? And yet they're still sending the corned beef over. They don't like us. You know what? Yeah, crafty buggers, they're leaving the keys off. See you later. Bye.
Body heat. Body mist plus. Body work. Body close. Body mist plus. Body power. New body mist plus. A big plus for anybody.
Better make a strong ball this time, eh?
Find your backs.
Sorry.
Nice arrows.
Strong bow. Strong, straight, true.
China, earthenware, electroplated metal, and stainless steel teapots are most suitable for making tea. The brew should be poured through a strainer into a second teapot. This will prevent the tea from becoming over-infused.
Oh, well, I'm not over-infused. I can tell you all that fuss just for one cup of tea. I use type 2 one cup. All these bags in the box means loads more for your money. Because every bag makes one perfect cup.
Oh.
Lovely. Not everyone who can make a good cup of tea.
You only get an oo with Typhoo.
It's taken the designer's art, the engineer's vision, to create the new British luxury saloon, to combine aerodynamics with beauty and stature, to balance smoothness of ride with full-blooded power. and to design a car that soothes and comforts, leaving the pressures of the day far behind. Power, prestige, performance. The new four-model Rover 800 series. Engineering in a finer form.
Doing fine.
Smashing. What are you doing up here?
Well, I just come to wish you all the best with the series, introduce a few old acts and some new ones. Why don't we take a look at this? Terrific, isn't it? That was the Vernon's girls. And the girl we stopped on was Vicky Brown. And the lovely Vicky's with us tonight to sing a new song that was written by her husband, Joe Brown. And she's accompanied by John Lord from Deep Purple. I know all this information. And here she is, the delightful Vicky with Lullaby. That was one of Liverpool's greatest comedians. It's great.
And isn't it funny, though, that Liverpool used to always produce great comics?
What do you mean, used to?
Well, yeah, I mean...
Look at Jimmy Tarbuck.
But, I mean, to say, look, I mean, out of Merseyside now, there's lots and lots of new comedians coming through. And there's another young one.
Oh, I bet that makes you feel old.
But it is.
Greg Rogers.
Thank you. Thank you. Good evening. Must say it's a pleasure to be here. It really is. Have you ever? I'm sorry, love. Can't you see? Have you ever noticed? Have you ever noticed how quick Liverpool people are? I think yes is the word you're looking for. I'll try and explain to you. I stopped for petrol in Liverpool the other day. I said to the girl, could you check me tyres? She went, you've got four. What about the fella walking through Liverpool? He's got two dogs on a lead. This other fella walked over to him. He said, are they Jack Russells? He said, no, they're our kids. Fella in a pub in Liverpool, and he's standing by the bar, and he's got his leg in plaster. And this fella looked at him, he said, have you broke your leg? He said, no, just had a lag for the winter. Twelve kids my mother had, you know, used to put on a pedestal. And that's who's keep away from me, Dad. I was the youngest of the 12, me, youngest of 12 kids. I tell you what, I used to get hand-me-down clothes, and he had eight sisters. I went to school one day, had the same dress on as the teacher. I think he was more embarrassed than I was, you know. See, we're quick at school as well, you see. That's the thing, because we learn it early. We're quick at school. When I was at school, they had this inspector from the education committee, and he was looking at the teacher, seeing how he took the class. The teacher said to one of the lads, he said, who knocked down the walls of Jericho? This kid stood up, he said, I never. Teacher said, all right, sit down, you know. Inspector said, what's going on here? He said, just ask that child who knocked down the walls of Jericho. He said, you never reprimanded him. She just said, well, I've known him for 4 years, and if he said he never did it. The inspector threw a wobbly. He went off to the headmaster. He said, I've just been in 4C. He said, I asked the teacher, that's one of the kids who knocked down the walls of Jericho. He said, he never did it. Teacher never reprimanded him. He said, he'd known him for 4 years, and if he said he never did it, what's going on? The headmaster said, I don't want any trouble. He said, yeah. These walls are Jericho. He said, what if I send a couple of bricklayers around Monday morning? Right. My impression of a Geordie John Wayne. Here we go.
Why are you booger?
Liverpool lad in a pub, and this fella comes in and he said, yes, sir, what would you like to drink? He said, I want numb and that. Numb and that, numb and that, numb and that. And he went with the boon. Fella said, I'm sorry, I beg your pardon. He said, I want numb and that. Numb and that, numb and that. Numb and that, and he went with the boon. But I'm sorry. He said, I can't understand you. He said, I'll get Harry the seller, man. He'll understand you. He phoned up Harry. He said, Harry? Harry said, yeah. He said, what? No, that's the wrong voice. Hang on. Get me voices mixed up. He said, come up and save this fella. He said, certainly. He said, certainly, what would you like? He said, I want numb and that, numb and that, numb and that. I'm in the glass with the boon. He said, certainly, sir. Gives him the drink. The fella said, thank you very much. Said, that was the best drink I've ever had. Walks out. The barman turns to Harry. He said, what exactly did he want? And he said, he wanted numb and that. And numb and that. Good night. God bless. Thanks a lot.
Now, Stan, here's a scouse who needs no introduction, so why should we bother? Let's go to the bar. Okay.
Here I'll stay. chair. Here we go. So, Mary, cross the Mersey, and always take me there, the place I love. People around every corner seem to smile and say, we don't care what your name is, boy, we'll never turn you away. So I'll continue to say, here I always will stay. So ferry across the Mersey, 'cause this land's a place I love, and here I'll stay. People around every corner seem to smile and say, don't care what your name is, boy, we'll never turn you away. So I'll continue to say, here I always will stay. So ferry across the Mersey, I love, and here I'll stay, and here I'll stay, here I'll stay.
Well, that's all for tonight. If you're in the area and you want a good laugh, drop into the Liverpool Festival of Comedy during the next couple of weeks. And we'll see you later this year. Ta-ra! We'll be right back.